Off the coast of French Guyana lies one of the world's largest coral reefs, only recently discovered. The Esperanza, part of Greenpeace's fleet, has come to explore this unique and extensive ecosystem. On board, scientists scan the waves from sunrise to sunset. They carefully record all the species they sight in this area rich with marine life.
We have an idea of how many species we have, of the diversity, but we have very little information on their habits, their migrations. Are there any births in French Guiana too? Is there any reproduction? We don't know much about these activities.
Encounters are plentiful. Biologists spot a school of whales in the middle of a hunt. And within minutes, the Zodiac is being launched under the watchful eye of the captain.
Okay, deck, bridge. As I said, when you're ready, you can put the boat out of the rail.
The race is on to catch up with the whales. Between the tuna and sharks, scientists observe the bride's whale for the first time in this area, a rare species they grow up to 16 meters long. This is proof for these naturalists that the area is far from being an oceanic desert.
If they feed here, it is because they are important areas for the survival of species. So inevitably, if there are too many disturbances, they will have to leave these areas, and it is not easy for them to find the same conditions in other areas. So it really can affect the survival of certain species.
The word survival might sound strong, but the threat from fossil fuel foragers is very real. Thiago, Almeida is from Brazil, where the Bolsonaro government wants to sell several hundred oil concessions on the Brazilian part of the reef.
In white, you can see the great Amazon reef system. Here, these squares are blocks that the National Oil Agency want to sell to oil companies here in Brazil. We are talking about a unique ecosystem not seen anywhere else in the world, and that we barely know, and it's already under threat from oil. A lot of oil would come to French Guiana. If we look at the oil spill modeling done by the companies themselves, you can see that the threat is real.
It's not just the reef which would suffer in the event of an oil spill. On land, mangrove forests stretch all along Guyana's coast, serving as crucial fish nurseries as well as absorbing carbon from the atmosphere.
In case of oil pollution, we could see oil pellets entering this mangrove. Bear in mind that this mangrove is still the breeding location for our fish. Renewable resources can allow us to develop in a sustainable way. However, some people have eyes bigger than their stomachs and consider that wanting to go and get oil or gold will allow us to become either an emirate or a remarkable jeweler for the planet.
This view is not shared by those counting on the economic benefits which oil can bring. For Guyanese fishermen, fossil fuel companies represent a chance to renew their obsolete equipment. Total had set aside millions for preliminary drilling, but was forced to abandon its plans after being denied a license by Brazil's environmental regulator.
This is Guyana's fishing industry, Creole canoes carved from a tree trunk. And if the project had been successful, we could have had the means to modernize our fleet and our port areas.
From its oceans to its forests, Guyana is rich in natural resources. But the questions of whether they should be exploited divides opinion in the capital, Cayenne. Some elected officials are hoping for a change in Guyana's status to bring total back.
It seems like there's everything we need to make Guyana almost a small Qatar. Yet, as I just told you, 60% live below the poverty line, public facilities are lacking, and the French state is drained and can't develop this territory through subsidies alone.
About 100 kilometres further north near Suriname, the inhabitants of this Amerindian village depend directly upon the sea. Reuben, a fisherman from the Kalina community, is wary of what black gold would bring.
I think it's bad for us, but I think it's petrol is dangerous.
But he feels his concerns are not being heard.
We have no weight. We don't make the decisions. Leaders have decided that they make the decisions. We're not consulted.
The fragility of the Amazon Reef underlines the urgency of reaching an international agreement. Experts on board Esperanza hope their findings will convince decision makers to sign an ambitious treaty to protect the oceans.